Hi, Matthew.
Hi, Dr. Ivy.
How are you?
I'm okay.
So what's been going on?
I noticed recently I do have some itchiness and pain around the mole right here.
Okay.
I'm a little bit concerned. I don't know exactly if I, you know, something that I did or it's from the mole itself. Do you see?
Okay, yeah. Yeah, it does look irritated around it. Is it just that one?
Just this one.
Okay. When did you notice that the pain started?
A week ago.
Okay, have you been to the beach recently?
No.
No. Or, I guess, tanning in general?
No.
No. How's your water intake?
I do drink a good amount of water, really? I think.
Okay.
Yeah.
Do you know how many ounces a day?
About 8 cups.
Okay, very good. Okay, so I'm going to be doing a detailed skin mapping exam. I want to make sure that there is nothing wrong with that one, and then I'll take a look at all the other moles on your upper body, okay? Do you have any allergies that I should be aware of?
No, I'm not allergic to anything.
And any medication that you take regularly?
No.
Can you just briefly describe what your skincare routine is like?
I wash it with soap and water, and I apply some lotion after.
Okay. Do you wear sunscreen every day?
No, not every day.
So sunscreen is very important, even when we don't think that the sun is too strong. Even when it's cloudy, it's important to wear sunscreen. So I'm going to be putting on my gloves and I'll start the examination. Start in this area. Okay, first I'm just taking a general look at your skin. I see a lot of dryness. Skin is peeling off in some areas. Looking for any signs of irritation, inflammation. Do you feel that?
Yes.
Can you just say yes when you feel it?
Yes.
Okay, definitely I can see a lot of scaly patches. But it seems to be pretty consistent everywhere, not specifically where the moles are located. Seems to be pretty regular in size and color, and the irritation seems to be on the surface skin layer around it, not really affecting the mole in this area. Check with UV light to make sure we look for different skin changes. I'm going to be taking some samples. Of the loose skin. Just gathering a sample of some of those loose skin cells. I'm gonna take a measurement of these. Mm-hmm. And I do want to make sure that we don't have any raised skin marks that are not noticeable to the naked eye, so this will help me detect any changes. I do want to apply some hydrating moisturizing oil on your skin. Since you're already here, and this is gonna help a lot with all this dryness and scaly patches. This oil is medicated. It contains very hydrating active ingredients. Some vitamin E. Helping promoting the oil to penetrate the skin and get absorbed so it can start working. I'm going to move on and check your chest and your face. Then we'll move on to the other arm. Okay, can you tell me your fingers?
Right.
Okay. Just taking a quick look. Just looking for any inflammation. and turn towards me. Okay, I notice very few moles on your face. I do see some that are pretty raised from the skin. So I'm gonna take a closer look at those. And overall, your skin looks irritated and very, very dry. You have a little bit of inflammation in this area. And I do notice a little bit of puffiness around the eyes. How's your sleep schedule? Do you get enough rest?
About 6 hours per night.
Okay. I'm gonna take a closer look at molds. Okay. I have a strawberry mold here. Pretty regular. Very normal, a little bit raised from the skin. Okay, I'm gonna have you turn your face that way. There are a couple of moles in this area. This one is very small. Another one here. These both look like sun spots. They're lighter in color, not raised from the skin. Okay. I have a little wart on this. Here you are. One more here. A little bit raised from the skin. Taking a measurement. Regular and symmetrical. This one here is 4 millimeters. 5. 3.5. Haven't noticed. if some cold therapy would help with some of the inflammation on your face before we move on. Okay, I'm going to be applying this cold glass massagers, and it's helping a lot with the inflammation. Now I'm going to be moving on to your other arm. Okay. Just at first glance, I notice there's a couple of moles, but this in particular looks a little bit irritated. Skin is also pretty dry. Just gonna take a closer look at the moles. This one looks a little bit irregular. It's not raised from the skin. Here is definitely erased from this. It's lighter brown, but pretty regular in color and shape. Not notice any changes. Layers of the skin that would be concerning. Did you look with the UV light to notice any girl, I just notice a lot of dryness, scaly areas. So definitely gonna be applying the same oil we applied on the other side. Just gonna go ahead and measure your moles. Okay, here we have 2 millimeters by 2.5. Now that will help some of that dryness and scaly areas on your skin. Now take a look at your scalp and make sure that dryness that I've noticed is not affecting your scalp as well. I'm just gonna keep this calm. Do you feel this? Feel this?
Yes.
This?
Yes.
Okay, I'll just
taking a look at your hair follicles here. There is a little bit of white scaly patches. It's definitely not as bad as your arm. I notice a strawberry mole here on your scalp. Looks pretty regular. Okay, same type of little white residue, definitely dead skin cells. There's one little follicle in this area that's a little bit inflamed. Okay, where do you usually part your hair?
On the side.
On the side, the side. You turn your head this way. Okay, so I find finding your natural part. It does seem that there is some sun damage on your scalp. This area, I notice some irritation. This way now.
So there is some irritation on your scalp as well. I'm gonna prescribe a shampoo. But for now, I do want to do some massaging to promote the blood flow in your scalp. And I'm just going to be using my nails. Trying to exfoliate some of those dead skin cells and promote some blood flow to your scalp. You might feel some tingling sensation after we're done, but that is normal, and it's just the accumulation of blood flowing towards the surface of your scalp. Concerning, there is an irritation around your moles, but it definitely is from your skin irritation. There's a lot of dryness. I'm gonna give you this oil and you can take it with you. Just apply it after you take a bath. It's gonna help just seal in the moisture from the bath. The bath helps open up the pores, so it's gonna be absorbing this a little bit better. And I think you should use it every day for the next week, and then you'll be doing a lot better. Okay? Do you have any questions?
No.
Okay. Okay, well, if anything comes up, definitely give me a call.
Okay.